Tonight's story on DSMY Newscast is somewhat unique and calls for a different kind of introduction. This, as you may recognize, is a maintenance service elevator, still in operation, waiting for you. We invite you, if you dare, to step aboard in tonight's episode, as Tower of Terror is the star, and this elevator will travel directly to DSMY Newscast. In tonight's episode, we are going to dive into the history, which you may or may not know, of the Twilight Zone Tower of Terror, and also the prospective future that awaits this iconic attraction. But to do this, we must start at the very beginning, 3,000 miles away in Paris, France. As the origin of Tower of Terror, which we all know and love, is derived from the very early planning stages of Disneyland Paris in the 1980s, as Imagineers had developed an attraction called Geyser Mountain, which would have been a free-fall ride where you would be propelled up through the mountain by the force of the geyser exploding beneath you. However, the initial financial struggles of this new park meant that this attraction would never be built. That is, of course, only in that iteration, as the attraction's ride system remained a popular choice within Walt Disney Imagineering. Orlando, 1989. Amid the glitz and glamour of the opening of Disney MGM Studios, the new park had been rushed to completion and only had two attractions when it first opened. However, despite this, the park proved to be popular, and so Disney decided to add new attractions. However, it was still in need of a true e-ticket ride, and Disney CEO Michael Eisner wanted it to be set within the horror genre to attract younger adults to Walt Disney World. You see, this iconic attraction wasn't always destined to encompass the fifth dimension, as Imagineering first explored the properties of Friday the 13th and Nightmare on Elm Street, but finally decided upon Young Frankenstein by Mel Brooks instead, as the attraction was originally themed more to a castle than that of a hotel, with a queue winding around a small Bavarian village before you crossed a drawbridge and into the attraction. But this concept was changed in favour of the Mel Brooks Hollywood Horror Hotel, which would have been in many ways a more comedic version of the Haunted Mansion. However, when Mel Brooks inevitably left this project, Disney called upon the Twilight Zone. Hidden secrets, special effects, ride mechanics, all of these things you probably know already. And if you don't, then peruse the links down below. However, next year will mark the 25th anniversary of this iconic attraction, and yet its future is far from certain. But to understand the chain of events that might unfold, we must first dive into the events of 2016. As it was in 2016 that rumors began circulating about space being cleared within the Tower of Terror at Disney's Hollywood Studios, with the main assumption being that Disney were looking to add a brand new bar experience, themed to that of the infamous Tip Top Club, which is within the attraction's narrative. However, these rumours proved to be false, but then came the second and most important event of 2016 for the Tower of Terror, when Disney unveiled plans to completely retheme the Twilight Zone Tower of Terror at Disney California Adventure into Guardians of the Galaxy Mission Breakout, with this instantly leading to the belief that this change was only the beginning, and Disney must have been making this change due to a CBS rights issue over the Twilight Zone brand. But with the benefit of hindsight, we can now see that the retheming of Tower of Terror at Disney California Adventure was part of a more strategic plan, as Disney were developing ideas for a Marvel superhero universe at that park, and the Tower of Terror would have simply looked out of place within that new influx of Marvel properties within that park. Then, in December of 2017, news broke that CBS had greenlit a reboot of the beloved Twilight Zone series, with Jordan Peele, who was the director and writer of the Academy Award-winning Get Out, set to helm the new TV series, with the intention to breathe new life into this cornerstone of TV history. And this brings us to today, as the modern-day Walt Disney Company have outlined a clear strategy in recent years. And that is to remove any intellectual property represented within Disney parks that they do not own, and replace these attractions with intellectual properties that they do. Which is completely understandable, as Disney want control over how that brand is represented. So, with the recent revival of the CBS Twilight Zone series, it seems that Disney will more than likely be looking to remove the Twilight Zone element from that attraction. However, don't expect any changes to occur until around 2020, as Disney will want to have Star Wars Galaxy's Edge and Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway open before making any changes to this e-ticket attraction. Now, the scope and scale of what these changes may entail is a different matter, as there have been many contrasting opinions on this subject. And I'd highly recommend going and watching a video by Rob Plays, as I'll leave a link in the description box, as he makes some very insightful points on this topic. But I personally feel that Disney could easily remove the Twilight Zone brand, but keep the feel of the attraction the same, as the disappearance of the guests and the haunted elevator aspect could all be explained through a different backstory. But it had been uncovered that this hotel was resting atop of a Native American burial ground, similar to the story behind Poltergeist. But that is just one example of how Disney could create an alternative ride narrative without changing the attraction drastically. But of course, it's quite possible that the Tower of Terror has transcended fiction and moved into reality, as on a fateful September evening in 2010, the impossible happened, perhaps moving the attraction forever into the Twilight Zone. But now, it's over to you, Walt and Iz. I would like to know, what would you like to see Disney do with the Tower of Terror over at Walt Disney World if they do decide to remove the Twilight Zone theming from that attraction? And what changes would you like to see made, and how would this adapt the story of the attraction to keep it maybe the same or make it a completely different type of attraction? And of course, don't forget to put the timestamp of where the hidden Mickey appeared somewhere within this video, along with your suggestion or your comment, to be in with a chance to win a DS my newscast pin. And congratulations to this Waltonier here for winning with this suggestion from the previous video, where we were talking all about the location of the Star Wars hotel that's going to be coming to Walt Disney World. And so that's it for today's video. So go ahead and subscribe down below if you're new to this channel. Hit that notification icon so therefore you always get an update whenever one of these DSMY newscast videos comes out. And also, if you've enjoyed today's video, give it a massive thumbs up, as it really does help this channel out. And I've been Jack. You've been you, and I'll see you real soon.